guys, so excited to be here. My name is Joy Williams. I'm Executive Master Level Educator with Farouk Systems. I am stoked to be here today on Cosmoprof's Facebook Live. Thank you all for joining me. Guys, listen, make sure that you're liking, that you're commenting, that you're sharing this video. I can't hear you, so I want you to talk to me. Go ahead and comment at the bottom. I'm coming to you guys today from Houston, Texas. Let me know where you're from. Hey guys, come on in. So we're gonna play today with some blonde techniques. We're gonna use my favorite lightener, the CHI Blondest Blonde. Have any of you guys heard of this before? Have you ever used it? So the CHI Blondest Blonde is an amazing lightening system. It's an ionic lightening system. And it comes in our 32 ounce as well as our 16 ounce. It also comes in our cream lightener. So I'll show you a few tips and tricks that I use with that today. It is ammonia free. It also has our far infrared technology that allows us to also add aquamarine in there. It's gonna lift and deposit at the same time. Listen, we are in the salon. I'm still working in the salon. I know you guys are. We gotta work smarter, not harder, right? So I'm gonna show you guys a few techniques today on how to get these beautiful blondes. I have my gorgeous model, Lake, here. And she is a blonde, and she's had some previous lightening. She came to us with some previous lightening already. Come in, look a little closer. So we went ahead and went in and kind of touched up some of her blondes. We went in already and just added a few. We used the Blondest Blonde to be able to achieve some of this lightening look. And listen, I love you, Lake, but I'm gonna tell you right now. Lake is our typical blonde client that likes to wait several months in between her touch-up services. So today, we're gonna go ahead and get her touched back up. She's got several inches of new growth. She has a few previous lightening here, and she's at about a level 7. So we're just gonna bring her all the way back up, go in, make sure that we take out any of these banding, some of these warm colors, and we're just gonna go in with that. Now, a few things about the CHI Blondest Blonde before I go further is that you're able to get up to 8 levels of lift. Okay, so you're actually able to do from deep colors all the way to pale colors in one sitting. This process we only did in one process, so you can see the drastic difference that we created. If you notice, my hair has a little bit of blue in there, and I achieved that also with our CHI Blondest Blonde and then some of our chroma shines. So you're able to really get those deep colors really light so that you can create a beautiful canvas. I'm just kind of cleaning my canvas out here today, making sure that we can prepare her to get these nice blondes, and also if she wants to do anything additional toning, different types of colors, we want to make sure that we clean that canvas out, get it really nice and even. So the CHI Blondest Blonde, you can use it with on or off scalp processes, and you're able to use it in the cream or the powder. Listen, I'm going to show you guys a quick tip that I like. I'm going to go ahead and go around here, and we're going to mix. So I take my CHI Blondest Blonde in the powder. I wish you guys had smell-o-vision. Come here. Listen, first of all, look how blue that is. That aquamarine is really gonna take out those brassy tones, those unwanted yellow tones, any of those tones in your hair that you're not gonna want, okay? So we're gonna get that removed. You're gonna lift, deposit, and tone all at the same time. Again, we're working smarter, not harder today, right? So I'm gonna go ahead and take my CHI Blondest Blonde. It smells so good. If you can't tell, I'm a little nasally today, thanks to my Texas allergies. And so I love the fact that this doesn't bother me. It doesn't make a stinky smell in my salon. It has like a rose fragrance to it. So it really helps me to be able to work very clean. Guys, you know, we're all now environment conscious. So we wanna make sure that we're working very clean. So I'm just gonna apply 1 ounce of our Blondest Blonde. It's powder, it's dust free. So it's not poofing all over the place. Then I'm gonna go in with our CHI Blondest Blonde cream, okay? I'm gonna mix that. This gives me a beautiful gel consistency that I absolutely love. So many of you guys have had to use clay lighteners in the past or different lighteners to be able to achieve. What I love about the Blondest Blonde is that I can manage what type of texture that I have with the Blondest Blonde. I'm able to make it really thick. I'm also able to make it thinner and still get the lightening power with balayage and different things like that we want to do. So I'm gonna go ahead and mix a little bit of this. Just take a couple of ribbons. And our formula today on her roots is we're gonna mix this with our 20 volume generator. Now let me tell you about the CHI generators. I like to call them generators because not only do they generate my lightener, but they also generate some money, okay? So I love doing lightening services in the salon. I love doing different balayage and techniques. And so our generators along with our lighteners work together. Now, a few things about our lightener as well is that it has silk protein. How many of you guys are familiar with silk protein? Somebody comment and tell me if you're familiar with silk protein. While you're doing that, I'll go ahead and tell you about it. So silk protein has 17 of the 19 amino acids naturally found in hair. So we're putting that in every product with Farouk Systems with CHI, but we'd certainly have that in our lightener. That is gonna help you to get nice, strong results. I'm a little bit of a nerd. So those of you that are following me that are nerds as well, say hey. So what I like about the silk proteins is this. Silk proteins are in a triangular molecule. So typically a molecule is circular, right? So if you put two circles together, you have like a gap in between. At the top and at the bottom, you have a gap in between. However, silk proteins molecules are triangular. So then that means when you stack them on top of each other, I'm gonna age myself right here, but it's like Tetris. There are no gaps in between each of these, right? What that's gonna do for you, that's gonna fill in any gaps, any holes in the hair. Because her hair is blonde, she's got a little, she's very porous. And so we're able to go in and fill in those areas, make sure that we keep it nice and strong, give strength and shine to the hair at the same time. So we're able to really do that. In addition, silk protein keeps those bonds intact. So there's no need to add any additional things. Silk protein is gonna keep those bonds intact, okay? So we're gonna go ahead and mix that together. Let me show you really quickly how I mix that together. So at her root, we're gonna use the 20 volume. At the ends, because they're already porous and they have a little lightening, we're gonna use a 10 volume, okay? So I'm gonna go ahead and mix this together for you. We have our powder, our cream, and our lightener here.
Hey Joy, Cold Steel asks, is that a zero lift?
Is it a zero lift? No, so we actually are able to, we did the 20 volume, and so we're able to get, with the 20 volume, you're actually able to get, remember I told you that we have up to 8 levels of lift. So a 10 is gonna act like a 20, you're gonna get up to two levels of lift with a 10. With the 20, you're gonna get up to 4 levels of lift because everything is gonna be multiplied by 2. Think about that when you're thinking about the CHI Blondest Blonde. Everything's gonna be multiplied by 2. So a 20 volume is gonna give you up to 4 levels of lift. A 30 volume is gonna give you up to 6 levels of lift. And a 40 volume generator is gonna give you up to 8 levels of lift in one sitting. Does that answer your question? Let me know if I answered it correctly. I wanna make sure that I answer it for you.
Cole also asks, the cream, what's the purpose of adding the cream?
So I like to add the cream just to give me a nice thick consistency. I use the powder, so let me say this, the powder and the cream both work amazingly by themselves. You can use them by themselves and still achieve amazing results. It's just a tip that I like to use in the salon to mix the cream and the powder together. One of the other things that benefits is that I'm gonna actually dampen her hair. And so we're gonna apply this on damp hair. Using the cream along with the powder creates a nice gel consistency that keeps the hair moisturized and saturated while it's processing. So the reason why I like to use the cream and the powder together is because I give myself a longer processing time before my lightener dries out. Because how many of us have dealt with that? That you're at the back, by the time you get to the front, your lightener has dried out. And so when it's dry, it's no longer processing. So when I mix the cream in with my powder, I'm able to give myself a longer processing time before it dries out. So then I'm able to achieve my results faster. Okay, cool. So we're gonna go ahead. Thank you so much for those questions, guys. Keep them coming, I love it. So we have her here. I'm just gonna take our mist bottle here. How you doing, love?
Pretty good.
So she's got a few processes in here. And so of course, you know, when you're working on your clients and you haven't seen them in a while, you gotta really go in here and really see what she's got on her hair. So this is one thing that you'll notice that I'm doing. So this is really hot, it's trending right now, all over YouTube, all over Instagram, all over Facebook I've seen. Have you guys seen balayage or lightening done on damp hair? Comment and let me know if you've seen it. I saw it earlier this year and I started doing it, fell in love with it. I'm gonna show you a few reasons why I like to do it on damp hair. If you notice, we're not getting her hair soaking wet. We're just gonna do it on damp hair, lightly mist, and that's just water in my bottle. There's nothing fancy or magical or special. It's just water in my bottle. But I'm just gonna go in and apply this on damp hair. Applying it on damp hair, also because her hair is so porous, it allows us to keep the moisture. Everything that we're gonna do with blonde hair, with hair that's porous, we wanna hold that moisture in. And I need my gloves here so that we can start to apply. I'll go ahead and section this small section out here. Now, the other thing that is very important about doing blonde hair is this. You wanna make sure, thank you, my dear. Gloves appear out of nowhere. I love it. You wanna make sure that you're taking small sections. So because we're doing a root touch up and her hair, you know, we're close to the root, I can use heat. When we use heat, we recommend 5 to 15 minutes of heat, of low heat. But however, I don't necessarily have to. And because we're only going about 3 levels higher, I'm gonna opt not to use heat on her today, but you can. But one of the things that you wanna make sure that you do is to use very small sections as you're applying. So we're gonna take about 1/4 inch section. I'm actually may even go in and make that closer to a 1/8. And like I said, the hair is already damp. I'm gonna go in with a little bit more of my generator here. So a little trick that we like to use in CHI, or we like to teach when we're in CHI, with CHI, is we say the thicker the quicker. So you wanna mix your developer thicker to make it move a little faster. Since I'm gonna be talking with you guys and I needed to slow down and move a little bit slower because it just works so good. It works so well that I'm gonna add a little bit more generator in there. What that's gonna do is help to slow down some of my processes so I can really show you the different techniques that we're gonna do. She's got, like we said, several inches of new growth. And so basically we're just gonna do a basic root touch up with her. We're gonna wait till the very last 10 or 15 minutes to pull it through on the ends just to make sure that our canvas is even all the way through. And so we'll go ahead and get started.
Hey Joy, Andrew asks, someone told me that you can revamp the lightener if it dries out by spraying it with CHI Keratin Mist. Is that true?
Absolutely. So our CHI Keratin Mist, I'm sorry, I didn't say that part. Let's talk about that. So our CHI Keratin Mist, this is our leave-in strengthening treatment. It is a porosity equalizer. It will allow us to go in and equalize that porosity. Now, as far as revamping the lightener or spraying the CHI Keratin Mist directly in, no. However, you can add a little bit more generator to be able to revamp that. Or if you need to add more of the powder or cream and then go back in and add more of the generator. You don't really want to dilute your bowl with anything, right? So if you're gonna add your CHI Keratin, you wanna make sure that your CHI Keratin Mist, you wanna make sure that you're adding that on the hair, not in your bowl, okay? So I'm gonna go ahead and add that. We sprayed ahead of time, which is why I forgot to add it on there. But we'll go ahead and spray it again because you can't get too much, right? So we used our CHI Keratin Mist. Go ahead and add that in. We have a nice damp canvas to work with. We're gonna begin in small sections, okay? Here's the thing. Now, as I said, I'm from Houston, Texas. I'm a Texas girl, and there's a restaurant here that it's a fast food restaurant and does this little trick, and I found that I can do it only with the CHI Blondest Blonde because I've tried it before, and honey, it was an epic fail. But I just want to show you the consistency, right, of the CHI Blondest Blonde. Can your lightener do this? You see how long I'm holding that? That's what we're talking about. That is CHI ceramic right there. Technology. So we're gonna go in and I'm just going to start right, because she's got so much regrowth, I can kind of start just about a half inch under her section, under her root, and I'm just gonna apply it. And you see how little product that I'm using and how much coverage I'm getting? Then I'll go in there, smooth that out with my fingers.
Cole asks, is the CHI Lightener oil-based?
It is a cream-based lightener. However, I believe the cream has oil based in it. Somebody want to fact check me on that? We have silken oil. We have silken oil in the product. So the silk protein and the oil helps to give us more of a more of kind of a give toward that. So there is silken oil in the cream powder as well. I mean, in the powder as well as the cream, but it's not an oil based. So if you're asking if our generators are oil based, no, because I've seen some brands where the generators are oil based. So our generators are not oil based, and neither one. Okay. So yeah, we have the silk protein, but not the not the oil. So again, I went in and saturated that. If you can see, I'll go and I'll touch up her sideburns here in a second. But you really want to take very small sections. That is what's going to be the difference in having a fully saturated blonde retouch versus, you know, one that has spotting in it. If you want to use foils, you absolutely can, especially if you're going to go more than 2 to 3 levels. Foils are great. They help to incubate the product and help it to really move fast. Also, cotton. Cotton is a great tool to use, a great way to get this in and saturated. But for the sake of time, again, we only have a short amount of time, I want to make sure that we get her fully, fully saturated. Being careful to keep it off her ears. So another thing that I love about our lightener is when we talk about the far infrared technology. So that allows the toning and the color. So we're using the far infrared technology with the aquamarine, which is what gives us our beautiful blue color. So what I love about that is that it actually allows us, when it's time to go ahead and deposit that color, when we allow the process to happen and then we allow that tone to go in, that's what's gonna go in and remove our brassy tones. So say for example, we do our hair, we put her under low heat for 5 to 10 minutes, because with her hair, I wouldn't do 15. We only need about 5 to 10 minutes with low heat. Then my cool down time is gonna be the most important. Hear me, the cool down time is the most important. That's where your tone comes in. That's where we eliminate those unwanted brassy tones. We eliminate some of those orange and yellow tones. She doesn't really pull orange, but she can pull really warm. So we're able to really go in and help to remove some of those tones with our far infrared technology and the aquamarine.
Hey Joy, Debbie asks, can you do a CHI retouch on hair that's been lightened by another product, and how would you even it out to the rest of the hair?
Absolutely, you absolutely can. So the first, of course, first and foremost, it's gonna be in your consultation to see exactly where the old product was and where the new growth stops. So you're able to go in and mixing your CHI Blondest Blonde together. One thing that is important when you're going behind old color, and all you stylists know it start with the B word, banding. So you wanna make sure that you're not getting any sort of banding. So what I would do is I would go in on the new growth only, go in like I'm doing today with our 20 volume generator, wait until like the last 10 minutes, right before she's done processing, last 10 or 15 minutes, and then go pull it through. Even if you need to add more pop product, go in with maybe a 10 and then pull that through to make sure that you prevent any banding. You don't want to cross over too much, but you want to make sure that you prevent any banding. So make sure that at the very end, you go ahead and pull it through the last few minutes so that you can prevent that. But yes, you absolutely can go over another line for sure.
Cosmoprof Willow Grove has a question. Is this lightener a runny, creamy consistency or more workable for balayage?
It is great for balayage. Did I just not show you my trick? So it's absolutely great for balayage. Let me show you the consistency here. So I'm mixing it up. Can you guys see that? You see how creamy that is? So what we're gonna do is we're gonna mix equal parts. So that's what we recommend, is to mix equal parts, your CHI generator, whichever you choose, and then go with your cream or your powder mixture. Now, again, remember I said our little trick, the thicker, the quicker. So you're gonna do equal parts. It's gonna give you this nice, even, kind of thick consistency. However, if you want to make it a little thinner, then you can add more generator. But here's the thing, it's still not gonna make it runny. You're still not gonna have to worry about it falling all over the floor. You're gonna be able to work clean. You're gonna be able to work efficiently and effectively. So yeah, you don't have to ever worry about it getting too runny, because if you put too much generator in it, then of course you're gonna completely dilute your lightener. But it does not get runny, and I've put a lot before.
For those who are just tuning in, what is mixed with the Blondest Blonde and what strength developer?
For sure. So hey guys, those of you that are just joining us, welcome, welcome, welcome. Make sure that you're liking and commenting. So what we have here is we are working with our CHI Blondest Blonde. That also doesn't fall. We're working with our CHI Blondest Blonde in our powder lightener. It's an ionic lightener, so it also those negative ions are gonna help go in there and strengthen the hair, make sure that color gets, the lightener gets anchored into the hair very well. And the trick that I like to use is I like to mix a little cream of our Blondest Blonde. So our Blondest Blonde also comes in a cream. So I mixed a little bit of the cream into the powder. So that way it gave us more of a gel consistency. So I'm able to really go in here. If we were doing a balayage, because we have to do so much in her root, I can't really show you a full balayage without compromising the style. But I certainly, if you wanna go in and do balayage, it's great for that because it gives you such a thick consistency and you're able to work with it. Also guys, remember this is ammonia free. So here's the thing about ammonia free lightener and everything that we make, our color, our lightening system, everything that we make is ammonia free. So here's the thing about ammonia free, it goes where you put it. The other side of that is if you don't put it there, it won't be there. So the lightener does not swell as much as other lighteners. It swells a whole lot less because there's not ammonia in there, right? And so what we're able to do with that is that you don't have to worry about it bleeding onto the next section. If you are doing foils, I know, you know, when I started cosmetology school, I had some smoky foils. I know you guys have had some smoky foils before, right? So you're not having to worry about it falling out of the foil and swelling all up and being all crazy. But the other thing about that is that you have to make sure that where you place it, it goes, because it's not going to swell up. So you have to be very clean and very precise with your movements and what you're doing. So you see, I'm going in, I'm giving complete saturation, top and bottom. And I've used so little product, like I have barely made a dent in my bowl. I love the questions, keep them coming. Also, with Lake's hair having previously been lightened, I wanna make sure that we are not compromising the integrity of our hair, which is why we started with the keratin mist to equalize the porosity. The CHI Blondest Blonde has a silk proteins in there. I just showed you how the silk proteins build on top of each other. So there's no gaps in between. It's filling in any little spaces. It's keeping those bonds intact. It's making sure that her hair, when it lightens, it's still gonna have the integrity. It's gonna be strong. It's not gonna be stringy. It's not going to overprocess, because that's the other thing. We wanna make sure that we don't overprocess. And so you're really able to maintain the integrity of your client's hair while still giving them the service that they asked you for. We're getting a little dry here, so I'm just gonna dampen her a little bit up. And so those of you that are just joining me, we're doing this service on damp hair. That does a few things. Of course, water adds hydration, okay? So it's gonna keep our service, our hair nice and hydrated throughout the entire service. Also, it's gonna keep the lightener processing. So when the lightener dries out, it's done processing. There's no more else that you can do to it. So in order to, instead of trying to re-wet it, what we're gonna do is we're gonna prevent it from drying out. And so we're applying it on damp hair. We're mixing our cream and our gel together. Our powder together to create a gel. And so that's gonna keep us moisturized throughout this entire service.
Joy, so Cosmoprof Willow Grove says they get one question a lot. Would yes. You still suggest a stylist to use a bond protector with CHI bleach?
It's not necessary. The silk proteins is what helps to actually go in there. Thank you for the question, guys. Hi. It's not necessary because the integrity of the hair is not going to be compromised because of the silk protein that's already added into your lightener. So, like I said, those silk proteins are going to go in there and they're going to help bond. Like, let me show you real quick. So, like I said, that molecule for a silk protein is a triangle. It's not a circle. So, whereas a circle, there'd be space at the top and at the bottom. And so, if you build those on top of each other, it's going to have gaps in between. We're playing Tetris. So, we're actually going to use the silk protein. And because the molecule is triangular, you're literally able to build it right on top of each other. So, there's no gaps. That's what keeps those bonds intact. So, no, you don't need to use an additional bond builder with our CHI Blondest Blonde. So if you ever see any CHI products or anything like that, it's gonna have that silk protein in there. How many of you, someone comment with me, how many of you have used the CHI Blondest Blonde? Tell me what your experience was. Comment below and tell us what your experience was.
Kelly Wright said that she used CHI Lightener yesterday. Mm-hmm. Her client didn't want ash or too much warmth.
Okay.
First time foil client and it came out beautifully.
That's what we like to hear. Hey. And her name is Kelly. Great job, Kelly. Thank you so much. Thank you for your comment. Yeah, so absolutely, I second what she says. She used the foils. It was a first-time client. She didn't want too much warmth or too much ash. And so we're able to really go in there and tone that. Again, we're going to lift, deposit, and tone all at one time. How is that for efficient work? As you see, we're just kind of working through here.
America says, he's never used it. How many levels of lift does it have?
It has up to 8 levels of lift. So your levels of lift is going to be determined by your level of generator. So CHI Blondest Blonde in the cream or powder form, because sometimes people wonder that, like, is the cream weaker or something? No, they both give you up to 8 levels of lift. And so how you determine that is with your volume generator. Again, like I said, a 10 volume, everything is going to be multiplied by 2. So a 10 volume is going to give you up to 2 levels of lift. A 20 volume is going to give you up to 4 levels of lift. A 30 volume is going to give you up to 6 levels of lift. And a 40 volume is going to give you up to 8 levels of lift. So you're able to get up to 8 levels of lift in one sitting without compromising the hair. That's the thing that's really important, because you can get there. What is the hair gonna look like once you get there? So I love the fact that we're able to do that and keep the hair healthy and intact. Keep those cuticles intact. So we're doing this on scalp application. Lake, are you burning at all, love?
Not at all.
Do you feel anything? Any tingling, anything?
Not a single thing.
Awesome, we love that. So this is certainly able to be used for on and off scalp applications, forehead applications, retouches, balayage, all types of different blonding techniques. So here's the other thing. This is what I love about this company. So Farouk Shami himself is a hairstylist. So he is a hairstylist. He understands that there are certain things that we need and there are certain things that we don't need. The one thing that we don't need as stylists is a whole lot of overhead and inventory that we can't use. Or we're not using, we're not moving off the shelf as quickly. So instead of having one lightener for balayage and then another lightener that moves quicker for, you know, my lunch ladies, I call them lunch ladies. So they come in on their lunch break and they need a quick touch up, they only have an hour. So I call them my lunch ladies because we get them in and out in an hour, right? So you may have a different lightener for that because, okay, this one moves faster than the other one. You may have a lightener for, you know, that allows you to kind of do multiple textures and hair types. So instead of having all that overhead, instead of having all that inventory, you have everything that you need in one. Okay.
Debbie says she's in for a CHI retouch.
Awesome.
Do it, girl.
Come see us, girl. Come see us. So we're going to go ahead and finish up here and just go ahead and process everything out. But I did want to go ahead and show you guys kind of what we did, what we're going to get at the end. So I'll go ahead and turn her around. Let me move this over so that you can see. I'm gonna spin you around real quick, Lake, so they can see. So we're able to get her to these tones lifted. We got a little bit of lipstick right there, but it's okay. We're able to get her lifted, deposited, and toned, all with the CHI Blondest Blonde. Listen, I know that as stylists, we rely so heavily on our toners. It's like, okay, if I can't get the color that I want, my toner is my next best step. We achieved all of this without really having to tone. So please understand that that cool down technique with the infrared and the aquamarine is gonna help you get these nice tones and tone out some of that brassiness.
We have a question from Angie. She says that she struggles with touch-up blondes. If your client is a level 5, how would you go about trying to do the new growth to do the touch-up to the rest of her blonde?
She's a level 5 at her root, and the ends are what level? They're just a blonde at the ends. So you want to make sure that as you're applying, first and foremost, with a level 5, you probably want to do some foils or some cotton in between just to incubate that color a little bit more, incubate that lightener. Use a CHI Blondest Blonde, mix it equal parts, and go ahead and apply that right to the root. And then go in and let that process, like I said, the last few minutes, go ahead and pull that all the way through. Okay, hopefully that answered your question. And we'll go ahead and wrap up here. So we'll go ahead and finish here, guys. You can stay tuned to the CosmoProf page for the final look. And one of the things we're gonna do with her once we're finished is go ahead and use our CHI Infra Shampoo as well as our CHI Infra Color Lock Treatment. That's gonna go back in. The cuticle has been raised with our lightener. It's gonna close that cuticle back down. Make sure everything is nice and moisturized and beautiful. And thank you guys so much. Again, my name is Joy Williams with Farouk Systems. I'm here. I would love to see you guys again. Let us know. Comment below. Make sure that you share. And we'll see you guys later.
Bye. Woo!